strength to start again. Sometimes it seems like I can never win.
What if, when I handed you that packet, I also gave you, let's see, a $10 bill? Would you take it? I mean, right, duh. But work with me for a second here. Say I rubbed under my armpits and then handed it to you. Would you still take it? Sure, it's still $10. Now, what if I wadded it up, spit on it, and stepped on it? Would you still take it? Let's see. Oh, that's kind of gross. But it's still $10. No matter what I did with it, its worth never changed. There are a lot of teens that are Christians that feel so far away from God. The way that they're living their lives is totally whacked out. I mean, every night they're on the party scene, boozing and doping it up. These Christians, they have sex with their boyfriends or girlfriends, or even the things that are coming out of their mouths. Total yuckness. No Jesus there. You feel like you've gotten so far away from God that he doesn't want anything to do with you. You feel worthless and dirty. And when people say God loves you, you say things like, but you don't know what I've done. Check out what the word says about you. Luke 15, 11 through 32. Once again, you're gonna have to whip out the book and look it up yourself. Don't miss the bus here. This isn't some little story you learned when you were a kid. This is about you, now, today. You may have run away from your father God. You may have sexed it up. You may have had an abortion. You may have partied so hard, dropped out of school. But you know what? It's time to come home. God, Dad, he's waiting on you. And he loves you so much. You're the son in the story, and God is the father, and he wants to throw this awesome party for you because you've come back. And that whole quote thing of you saying, well, if he knew what I did, then he wouldn't want me, can't cut it. You know why? Because he does know. And the thing is, he does want you. All right, you are the $10 bill. You are God's valuable child. You may have crumbled up, stomped on, and totally trashed your life. But you are loved by God the same as you were the very first day you gave your life to him. Hey, I got another life link for you. It's 1 John 1, verse 9. Look it up, write it down, whip out that note card. There you go. 2, 1, 2. All right, you got two of them now. Keep count of them, memorize them, keep them in here. I'm serious. You got to do it. It'll help you. Just know him. Life link. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. 1 John 1:9. Again, take out a card and write down the verse. Learning. Test others in your crew. Push each other to get these verses in your life. If you have gone off and done your own thing and not really worried about where Jesus is in your life, right now is for you. Do-over. That's so cool, huh? I mean, God is so cool because he gives you do-overs. No matter what you've done. He's okay with do-overs. He's okay with do-overs. He wants you to come back to him. He's waiting for you. He's waiting on you to make a move. What are some things that you've been into that you know are so not God? Scribe it. Don't just keep reading. This is for you and God. You don't have to show it to anyone else. What are some actions, thoughts, baggage you have that you want to get rid of? Such as drugs, jealousy, sex, lying, laziness, you get the picture, etc. Do over rules. 1. Tell God you're sorry that you've run away from Him and ignored Him. 2. Tell God thank you for taking you back and letting you start over. 3. Tell your group about it. Tell them that you made a commitment to follow Christ full on. Pray something like this. Father, I know I ran away from you. I'm sorry. Forgive me for I'm back. I know you love me. Thanks for welcoming me back. Help me get stronger so I won't run away again. If you've stayed with your Father God and your relationship is getting stronger, I would like you to take a pencil or pen or whatever you'd like, take your packet, and write something down. Scribble down exactly what happened, you know? You'd like to know, really. Next meeting, share it, man. Or woman, we'll do it. If you have stayed with the Father and your relationship with God is solid and getting stronger, then write a short prayer right now about two things. 1. Thank Him for keeping you close. 2. Pray that everyone in the group will stay solid. Alright, final thing that I want to add. God loves you no matter what you've done. So get back to God. Do over. Do over. See you tomorrow. Remember guys, God loves you no matter what you've done. He wants to help you. Get back to God and do over. You have survived day 2.